That's me walking out behind Last One's corporate headquarters in Columbus. Currently, it's 90 degrees on a summer day. I buttoned up my sleeves and I took 10 minutes of just average walking to see how hot I could get and how miserable it would be at 90 degrees. And I wanted to do this to compare what it must be like to be a blaster painter, wearing a nylon or leather suit, a helmet, and gloves in such unbearable heat. Well, today's Primed Insight is how we're gonna cool you down, because we're comparing cooling tubes.
Welcome to this week's Primed Insight. Recently, an early summer heat wave resulted in a customer calling us to complain that his C40 cooling tube wasn't as good as his previous blue cool tube. Now, the C40 was supposed to be an upgrade. It was supposed to drop the temperature in his blast helmet more than the blue tube, and yet it made things hotter. He wanted to know what was going on. So this gives us the perfect opportunity to explain the difference between the three most common airflow devices to ensure you get the maximum comfort you're expecting. Here's a quick refresher. The constant flow simply controls the flow of the air from the Radix breathing air filter, but it does not provide any heating or cooling capabilities. The Blue Cool air tube improves upon the constant flow device by cooling the incoming air up to 33 degrees Fahrenheit or 18 degrees Celsius. There's also a red heat tube for those cold months. And the C40 improves upon the cooling capabilities of the blue tube. It can cool the incoming air up to 52 degrees Fahrenheit, 29 degrees Celsius. And the same device can also heat the air for cold weather. The C40 is definitely the premium option. So in our customer's case, why was it not cooling as well as the blue tube? So here's what causes this issue. While the C40 does have the highest degree of cooling capacity, it's conditional upon your blasting setup. Now, whether you should use the C40 versus the blue cool tube comes down to how big your blast crew is and the equipment being used. Let me explain. First, let's talk about the equipment. The primary determinant is which Radix breathing air filter is being used. The two outlet version has a capacity of 30 CFM, while the six outlets capacity is 75 CFM. The next factor is that your setup is using the correct RPB fittings and breathing airlines as per the user instructions. That ensures NIOSH certification. And finally, we need to consider how many CFM the respective airflow devices consume, as well as the PSI flowing through them. The base model constant flow tube consumes 12 CFM. The blue and red tubes consume about 20 CFM, and the C40 can consume up to 25. Now let's talk about the size of your blast crew. When you have a single operator, the two outlet Radix is perfect because one outlet is always dedicated to the CO monitor. With the 30 CFM capacity of this unit, it supports any of the climate control devices, even accounting for a few CFM required by the CO monitor. It gets a little more complicated, however, when you have multiple operators running off the same breathing air system. Now in theory, the six outlet Radix should be able to support five blasters plus the CO monitor. But in practice, however, because it has a 75 CFM capacity limit, this capacity supports five operators only if all are using the constant flow tube. When using the blue and red tubes, the 75 CFM capacity of the six outlet Radix will truly only support three operators. With the C40 device, it could even be as low as two operators, you know, with the ability to add a third as long as they're using the blue tube. It's like a game of mathematics where the equation can even change due to the pressure drops caused by compressor size, length of breathing airlines, etc. Therefore, if you wish to provide the premium C40 climate control cooling experience for your blast crew, make sure your equipment is set up and performing to the specs of each device, and then depending on how many are drawing off the filtered air, you may need multiple Radix systems to accommodate the cooling requirements of each tube. If you are concerned about exceeding breathing air recommendations, you'll want to watch this video next. Keep cool in those hot temperatures, my friends, and thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight.